is it important for animals to hide in their habitat? Well, of course there's the predation factor. Most species are preyed on by something else, unless they are the predator. Even predators are preyed on by other predators. They need to be able to hide away in behind foliage of some sort, or blend in with their surroundings to try and evade predators. It's the bottom line. Animals use a variety of methods and techniques to hide away or to blend in with their environment. It usually involves color variation on the animal itself. So it will be a color that either blends in with the surrounding color, or it'll be a variety of colors that will break up the outline of the animal so that it blends in at a distance. Of course, some animals are smaller and they hide away in bush better, but nearly all animal, whether it's small or large, being preyed on, is going to have some form of color to make them blend in better. Let's look at the Tragelaphus family, or Tragelaphus as some people pronounce it, which are your spiral horned antelope, like kudu, bushbuck, and nyala. They've got a darker color which will blend in with the bush. So when they're inside the bush, they are a lot harder to see. Okay, so there's a variety of following techniques that animals have, and it's usually animals that live in herds, gregarious animals. For example, in a herd of impala, they've all got three black stripes on their backside, which they use to follow around normally when they're walking. But as soon as they take off away from a predator, they'll throw a white tail up into the air, which is very disorientating for the predator, for starters, but also as they're running, they've got something to focus on and follow with each other. Waterbuck have got this interesting following flag, if you want to call it. They've got a white ring on their backside, and as guides, we often say that they've sat on a wet toilet seat, because that's what it looks like. And that's ideal for them. They've got a really dark color and blend in, but that white marking stands out for the others to follow. Situations where animals don't really need camouflage or use camouflage are very often the species which live in the plains areas. In a plains environment, a lot of animals might have some kind of camouflage that breaks their outline, so at a distance they're not spotted. For example, zebra, giraffe. But when you get down to the smaller antelope, they're quite easy to see in the plains. But what these animals are relying on is that they've also got an advantage of seeing the predator coming. They take turns being on lookout all the time. And then they might have some type of evasive means when the predator does start its chase. Safety in numbers helps a lot. What I've even seen is different species congregating together in the same area. And it's usually these plains species, the animals that are out in the open plains, that can't really rely on camouflage because they don't have it. For example, a blesbuck or a wildebeest really stands out from its environment. Elephant and rhino don't really need any camouflage because they're such large animals. Most predators, especially even lions, won't even try and take on an elephant or a rhino. However, they are pretty camouflaged. Depending on what type of soil they throw on themselves or roll in for the day is almost what color they're going to be. And it can be quite difficult to spot them in the bush anyway, but they don't need it at all. predators also need to be camouflaged. It's not just the prey. While the predator is stalking their prey, they need to blend in so that the prey doesn't see them coming. The lion as the apex predator has also got camouflage. Most of the hunting environment that lions will be in is a golden yellow grass. And through time, they have evolved to be that golden yellow color. However, the lions do have little black markings behind the ears and the tip of the tail that they can spot from behind. It's for strategy, so that they know where the others have gone. Ultimately, the animal that is best at hiding will win nature's game of hide and seek.